Hi, I recently came across this demo. You can see how it works as I'm moving the mouse cursor left and right. Today I'll be coding a version that doesn't need any text application and it doesn't need any JS. And it also uses scroll instead of mouse move because scroll feels more intentional and more reliable. You can see how here I've exited the demo area with the cursor from the left side, but the separator didn't go all the way to the edge. Most importantly, it's the perfect chance to show you a new and exciting CSS feature that you may not know about. So let's dive right into it. So we already have our header right there in the HTML, and here in the styles we already have a font set for the heading and for the span, which is that cursive better. I didn't mess with those. We also have some custom properties set. We're going to see what the deal is with those later, but for now we're going to want to create a scroll bar, and we do that by creating overflow. So we're going to make the HTML overflow the viewport. We're going to give it a height that's twice the height of the viewport. It can be three times, it doesn't matter. Okay, Firefox is really bad at making this obvious, but I hope you can see the scroll bar. And we don't want that text to go up when we scroll. So let's fix the header. So, header, it's going to have position fixed. We're also going to do a few layout styles here. So we're going to have display grid. We are going to set explicit dimensions. So width and height. And okay, I think we can collapse the header now, so we can save space. And here we're going to want to place this heading right in the middle of its parent, right in the middle of its grid cell. Its parent only is a grid with a single grid cell, so it's basically the same thing in this particular case. Okay, so we're going to have place self center, which puts it in the middle of its grid cell. And it only seems like it worked vertically, and that's because its width initially is the width of its parent, but if we restrict its width to, let's say, 80%, you are going to see how it's also in the middle horizontally. Okay, the interesting part. So we are going to have on the body, on the heading, and on the span, a background. So this background is going to be this C0 custom property, and it looks absolutely horrible right now. So what we're going to do is, for the heading and the span, we are going to restrict the background to just the text area. So span background, so we're going to clip the background to just the area occupied by the actual text. Background clip text. Now, this looks better, but we are still not seeing the background for these. We are seeing the text color. So we are going to set the text color to transparent so we can see through it the background behind. Okay, now one thing I want you to notice right here is that we have a bit of black there and there. So those vertical lines beyond which we have black, those are the lateral edges of this span's box. So we need to expand the span's box horizontally, and we do that with padding. So we are going to set padding there, 0 vertically and 2 pixels horizontally. And now you are going to see that it looks a lot better. Okay, now let's make things more interesting. We are not going to have just a solid background. We are going to have a linear gradient. Red, blue. And this looks hideous, but it doesn't matter. Let's say that we are going to restrict the background size. So we are going to attach this to the left, 0 along the x-axis. And we are going to restrict the background size to 85%. And we're also going to set no repeat, because otherwise it repeats horizontally. And yeah, we're not really seeing anything. Okay, now one thing I want you to notice is that 85% means three different things for these three elements. So here for the background, the 85% line is right there. For the heading, the 85% line is there. And for the span, the 85% line is there. So how do we make them coincide? How do we make them all relative to the viewport? So we want to make this 85% always relative to the same. So we're going to set fixed. Now this is going to make that 85% relative to the viewport. Okay, but we don't want that gradient. We're going to want to have something like this, and we're going to take this color from there, right? That's going to be a C1, like that. Okay, so now this looks a lot better, and you can see it, you know, for 65%, right, or for 35%. Okay, now let's make this line move for real, not just by changing that background size value. So we're going to have a set of keyframes, call it grow, and at 0% it's going to have background size 0, okay, and then it's going to go to 100% there, and here we're going to have animation grow 1 second linear forwards. Okay, so it looks like something, but we don't want this to happen on load, we want it to happen on scroll. So here's where the really interesting part comes in, and we're going to use scroll driven animations. So we're going to set animation timeline, we don't even have autocomplete for this, to scroll root. Okay, so now you can see, right, when I scroll, so this happens on scroll, and it's really cool. Now, what about support? Well, in Firefox, as you can see, it's working, but it's working because I have a preference enabled in about config. So it's this preference, right, and it's set to true. But if I were to disable it, let's make sure I've saved this, right, then you can see the animation on load and then nothing happens on scroll. So that preference needs to be enabled in Firefox. Now, Safari, it just doesn't work. So Epiphany is like a real mess. And it's also a mess from other points of view. So I never set a vertical size for this gradient. So right here, I only set the horizontal size along the x-axis. And by default, and per spec, the vertical size should default to 100%. This is what the spec says, this is what Firefox does, this is what Chrome does. Epiphany does differently. I don't know if actual Safari does differently. So yeah. But now let's move on to Chrome and support for scroll-driven animations. And of course, Chrome has a different problem, which is it needs the WebKit prefix there. Now, okay, so now you are going to see it working. And at the moment, it is working because I have the experimental web platform features flag enabled. So in Chrome flags, it is going to work without needing this flag really soon. So yay for that. But for now, it doesn't work without the flag. So here I'm in Chrome dev, right? But in stable, I have this flag disabled. And you can see that nothing happens on scroll. And if I refresh, you're going to see the animation happen on load. And we don't like that with animation happening on load. So we are going to put everything inside a support. So we're going to test for support, if that thing is supported. So supports, right? And then we are going to put all this stuff. Let's collapse the header, right? We're going to take all this stuff and we're going to put it inside this support. And we're also going to take this part because the background overrides that background clip, right? So we need to put it right here. So this background declaration was overriding that. Okay, so now it works again. Now, something else we can do, you're going to see how now it looks very plain. So let's make it look decent at least. So let's set a color right there. And for the body, we are going to set the background to also the C0 custom property. Okay, and now it should look decent. Hello, the body. Okay, now it works. Okay. So something else we could do is add a warning. So I've been adding this lately. So these dynamically displayed support info boxes. In this case, all the features I've tested for are supported, but in our case, sometimes they're going to be supported, other times they won't be supported. Now let's see our info box. Right, we're going to take the class from there and style it. Right. So for now, we are not seeing it because we have support and we have set the color transparent. But if we set the color right here, so if we set color to white, then you are going to see the text. Okay, we are going to want to give it position fixed. We're going to want to attach it to the bottom and to the lateral sides. So we're going to have inset auto at the top, 0 for the laterals, 0 for the bottom, and margin 1mm, padding 1mm. We're also going to want to set a border. So we are going to use that color scheme. So border left solid 5 pixels, and of course we're going to need only one of those two colors. And then we're also going to set a background like this. Let's also prettify the font. So let's bump it up a bit and set a line height as well, right? And so here it's going to be like that. And let's also set a semi-transparent background. So we're going to have the hue won't matter because it's going to be a semi-transparent black. The saturation is going to be a 0, but again, it's not going to matter. And the lightness is going to be a 0 for black. And let's say we're going to have something like 0.5, and you can see how it goes right next to the edge. So we're going to set padding 2 pixels. I think we can get that down. Okay, and let's prettify this a bit more with a box shadow. 2 pixels, 2 pixels, 5 pixel blur, and the same shadow color. Yeah, pixels. Okay, I think that could have been a bit higher. More like that. Okay, that's nicer. But we don't want this to be displayed if we have support for scroll-driven animations. So here we are going to set display none. Okay, so we are not seeing it here, but if we don't have support, we are going to see it. Yeah, there are some problems with Epiphany. Anyway, one more little thing we can do to prettify things. So let's say scrollbar color. And this is going to be the thumb and the track. And this is for Firefox, sort of doing something, but not ideal. Now, for Chrome, we're going to need something like this, and we're going to set width like that, twice more, and we're going to have track and thumb, and this is going to be background. And here we are going to have for the track as Gainsborough, and here something like that. Let's see it. Okay, now you can see the custom scroll bar too. And yeah, that's it. So this is what I wanted to show you for today. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, if you like the work that I've been putting out for over a decade now and you want me to be able to do more in the future, please consider supporting it. You can do so by being a cool cat and becoming a patron on Patreon. Or if monthly support is not your style, there's the option of a one-time donation. The links for everything are going to be in the description. Not just the donation links, the links for resources, for the actual code and everything else that might be useful on this topic. Or you could at least share this to show the role that can be done with CSS these days, because honestly, I think it's pretty damn cool. In any event, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.